talk a little bit about the history of the periodic table, and then talk about how it's organized and designed. So, the history goes back to 1789 with the very first attempt to organize the elements. And it was this French guy named Antoine Lavoisier who just decided to group the elements into metals and nonmetals. And the first person to make the foundation of the modern periodic table was Dmitri Mendeleev in 1869. So he wasn't the first person to do this, but he organized the elements according to their atomic weights. And he did something that no one else had done, which was he left spaces for elements that hadn't been discovered yet. So at the time, we only knew about 63 elements, but scientists were discovering new ones all the time, so they knew that there were probably more. Now, there are 118, and 20-something of them are artificially prepared and not naturally occurring at all. But in the 15 years after Mendeleev's periodic table, we discovered 3 of the elements that he predicted. So, and the last elements to be added to the periodic table were in 2015, and they added 4 new elements all at once. So, starting in the early 1860s, there was a list of atomic masses published that, according to the Royal Society of Chemistry, fostered real progress towards the discovery of the modern periodic table. So the first person to use atomic mass to organize the elements was John Newland, and he published a couple of tables from 1864 to 1866 in a journal called Chemical News. And he had this thing called the law of octaves, which he framed after the musical concept. But that's not how the periodic table is organized anymore. So at the time that Mendeleev was working, we didn't know about subatomic particles. The first one to be discovered was the electron in 1897, and then in 1910, we found out that the nucleus existed. The structure of the atom is a cloud of electrons surrounding a small, dense nucleus that we now know is made up of neutrons and protons. We didn't know neutrons and protons existed until the 1930s. But in 1913, the scientist named Henry Moseley used X-rays to measure the wavelengths of different elements and then did some math that I don't really understand to determine their atomic number, which is what we use now. Nowadays, we know that atomic number is equal to the number of protons in an atom's nucleus. But again, we didn't know protons existed at the time. So, a modern day periodic table. You can see this one is the official periodic table of the National Institute of Standards and Technology. It has this right here, which has 13 fundamental constants of physics and chemistry, but it shows all of elements. So there are normally 4 pieces of information in a box on the periodic table. You can see the atomic number, the element symbol, the name, and the atomic mass. Because this periodic table is intended used by professional scientists, it also has standard atomic weight, ground state configuration, ground state configuration, and ionization energy, which are numbers that you need to use very often in lower level science. Some periodic tables just have two pieces of information on them, the atomic number and the element symbol, but must have the four that I mentioned earlier. And then periodic table is organized into groups, which are the columns, and periods, which are the rows, and also into blocks. You have the first block, the S block, that is the first two columns, selenium. You have the P block, which is the last six columns. And then you have the D block, which is the transition metals, columns 3 through 12. And then down here, you have the F block, the lanthanides and the actinides. Now, if you can do the whole periodic table from the first group to the 18th group, including the Bs up here, but it, because there are 14 elements per these rows, it gets very wide and it takes up way too much space. So they normally put them down here because they share a lot of the same properties. That's the periodic table. There's way more to find out. A lot more people have done work on it. And there's other ways to organize it, but